Then
this care, this is going to be amazing actually, because people here need to get away from stress and the stress of work and everything and the political issues here in Egypt. So we need to do something that gets them away from this, which is going to be something with a code of smile or something positive.
Do you think that Egyptians need to learn more about how to enjoy their lives? We don't know how to entertain themselves. I think that we need to know more about this.
Yes, I agree with that, because when you're satisfied with yourself,
yes.
You get satisfied with everything else. So I think the main solution for this is gratitude, to thank God for everything, so we can give more.
What makes students satisfied?
What makes students satisfied? Okay.
What makes you satisfied? What makes your friends satisfied? Or happy or smile?
On my personal scale, what makes me satisfied is to accomplish something that I really need to do. Like a project, it needs to be finished this week, so I'm going to finish it. Maybe others think that more free days is going to be better, and fun days in the university. So everyone has his own way to smile.
We always have free days. We have vacations more than any country on earth, actually.
Not exactly, but maybe because we're students, we don't feel that.
And when you organize these events, do you invite people from outside the university, or only students participate from inside the university?
Mainly the students from the university.
You don't sell tickets for people to come and make some charity work?
Okay, well, it's going to be free, even if we invited anyone else, it's going to be free because it's non-profit.
Yes.
And I wish I can spread that all over the universities here in Egypt, because we all need to smile.
You didn't think about schools, secondary schools or high?
Actually, we thought about that, but...
You know, even the kids, something very strange, even the kids, they are not happy. They don't want to smile. Maybe because they have a lot of homeworks. Okay, I can understand this. But do you think we can include them in this?
Of course, yes, but this is going to be much bigger scale to think about right now. But kids, I think maybe because the cartoons nowadays, it's not so like old days like Tom and Jerry and all the things that made us smile when we were young. Now it's all about
more space.
Yes. How would they smell?
So what are you studying, your major?
My major is accounting.
Is what?
Accounting.
Accounting.
Yes.
So you have to be happy.
Yeah, I'm really happy. I love my major actually.
And about your future plans, you plan to be an accountant. How can you use this idea of being positive in your life and apply it in your work? And of course, this will add more to you.
Well, I'm going to continue my career as a financial analyst.
Yes.
Because I like finance.
Yes.
I don't like numbers so much, but I like finance actually. I think that I'm going to reach my role, which is going to be one of the big four in auditing. Besides that, I want to work in finance. And that's mainly my aim. So I'm going to study and do my master's. I'll do my CFA, or Chartered Financial Analyst.
Don't you want to study some, to have some knowledge about the human development, as you are interested in positivity and smiling and happiness?
Yes. Of course, yes. I love reading books, but self-development, and my favorite is The Magic by Ron DeLaren. It's a book that talks mainly about gratitude and how to say thank you in different ways to different people. With any religious views, not only for Muslims or Christians or Jews, just for everyone, how to say thank you.
So tell us more about how to say thank you.
Okay, the book is like split into many chapters.
Many chapters.
Yes. Chapter 1 is talking about how to say thank you for the money you've been given. Chapter 2 is about how to like thank someone for making something to you. What else?
noticed something like it has to do with our habits, for example, that still whenever you have something, you think of having more. And it also has to do with the organization itself, because just as you mentioned, for example, talking about economic changes, talking about money in general, about the income, it is how to take benefit, how to put your priorities, back to time management, how to put your priorities so as to know what are you going to spend, how much do you have, many, many other issues, not only it has to do with the fact of being only satisfied, but it is something like a technique that you have to apply in your daily life. You agree with me?
I do agree, because I live by myself for 3 years now. So, of course, you have to manage your things by priorities.
How to schedule
yourself? Yes,
because this has always been the problem. For example, as long as we're talking about human resources in general, for example, you have the idea of the objectives, how to put objectives, and definitely no one can live without objectives. Not only the entities or organizations, you yourself or we, each one of us. And we have to learn that objectives must be achievable. Just as I mentioned in the beginning, it doesn't mean that if I want to do it, I will do it. It has to be achievable, because there are certain people, if they did not achieve what they want, they will be frustrated and they don't want to try again. Even though the successful people, they tried 100 times on one thing, at the end they are able to do it.
Well, about priorities, you have to do things first.
Yeah, apply this.
Yes, of course, yes. About giving up in something, no, that's not a choice for me. I never lose hope.
Persistence.
Yes, very. I never lose hope in doing something. I want to do this, so I'm going to do this. No matter what time it takes or what circumstances or whatever. So, yes.
So, you don't put for yourself a time limit, but you have to.
Yes.
Because sometimes, you know, if you're going to put your plan and you live with the plans 10 years, for example, but this is the issue. This is when it comes to marketing, when it comes to putting objectives. And why I'm asking this, because also I want to ask you, why is it important to have, for example, such events in universities, especially when it comes to having celebrities? And when it comes to celebrities, I can see that you are choosing young celebrities, that they are at least of the same age or close to the age of the students. It makes a difference. Why?
Because they are, as you said, they are our age, so they understand us, they know what things to say to make us laugh, to make us smile. They know how to draw a smile. That's how I describe it. So Arabia is a really funny person, so we chose him as a guest, and he came. Everybody, like 1,000 or 2,000 students, they are laughing all over the place.
But I think Hani Hussein also is...
Yes, of course, yes. Hani Hussein started to sing, and everybody was like, wow. So it was an amazing event, actually. Students were really happy and really positive.
So it's no secret that everyone has his own griefs and problems. So in your opinion, how can people deal with sadness and depression and maintain a positive look to their lives?
Well, actually, I've been into a lot of depression weeks in my life, but I only handled this by thanking God for everything good passed by my life, or everything good I did.
So in your opinion, maintaining a good relation with God is a key to happiness?
Meaning gratitude, this is the solution, the only solution. Being satisfied with everything that happens to you, being satisfied to the things that happened will make good things happen. A day starts with bad thing will never ever complete the bad statement or the bad day. So we have to make positive things to make it good.
And also to be in good terms with all colleagues. And I think this is also something of great importance, because talking about students, and these are the students of the universities, they are the leaders of the future. So when it comes to the idea of the teamwork, which we really lack in Egypt, it's not a part of our culture. Not only Egypt, by the way. For example, the United States, for example, is the same. Not like China. There are other countries who are following the idea of the teamwork. The credit is for the team. Do you think we can work on this as well? Because this can be another source of satisfaction.
Of course, yes, because...
Does the idea of teamwork exist?
Of course, yes, because my team is a small team. They're all good to get students this small. For example, we like divided the work and the roles into we're the social media. We're going to distribute candy. We're going to do that. We're going to do this. So everybody was like collaborating to do something in order to give a message to people to stay positive, to be happy.
Okay, and so Mohammed Radha, organizer of the event of Smile, thank you for being with us today. Now, with the viewers, we'll go for a short break and we'll resume breakfast shows. So stay tuned.